In this lesson, I am going to present what you can expect to learn by viewing the Infinite Skills Learning SolidWorks 2015 video training lessons. Let's begin by going over some basic terminology used in SolidWorks and the design industry in general. First, SolidWorks is a parasolid-based solid modeler and utilizes a parametric feature-based approach to create parts and assemblies. Now, what do I mean by parametric feature-based approach? The key word is parametric or parameters. Parameters refer to the constraints whose value determine the shape or geometry of the part or assembly. Parameters can either be numeric parameters, such as the length of a line and diameter of a circle, or geometric parameters, such as tangent, parallel, concentric, horizontal, or vertical. Numeric parameters can be associated with each other through the use of relations, which allows them to capture design intent. So now, what is design intent? Design intent is how the designer of the part wants the part to respond to changes and updates. For example, you would want the hole at the top of a soda can to stay at the top surface, regardless of the height or size of the can. SolidWorks allows the designer to specify that the hole is a feature on the top surface, and will then maintain the design intent no matter what size or height of the can. Now let's discuss what will be covered in the following lessons. Building a model in SolidWorks usually begins with a 2D sketch, although 3D sketches are available for power users. The sketch can consist of geometry such as points, lines, and arcs. As you create the sketch, geometric relations are automatically added to the sketch, such as tangency, parallelism, perpendicularity, and concentricity, to name a few. If needed, you can add geometric relations manually. After the geometric relations are added, dimensions are then inserted into the sketch to define the size and location of the geometry. The dimensions in the sketch can be controlled independently or by relations to other parameters inside or outside of the sketch. The parametric nature of SolidWorks means that the relations and dimensions drive the geometry. In the sketch lessons, you will cover many, if not most, of the sketch tools, from lines, circles, arcs, all the way through sketch patterns and repairing problem sketches. You will also cover good sound sketching practices to follow as you build your sketches. So when you complete the lessons on basic and intermediate sketching, you will have a good foundation to build from. The next area you will cover is part creation through the use of 2D sketches and 3D features. After the sketch is completed, you then utilize the appropriate 3D feature to give you the desired results. Features are the building blocks of the part. They are the shapes and operations that construct the part. A feature typically begins with a 2D or 3D sketch. Once the sketch is completed, it is then extruded to add or subtract material from the existing part, as an example. Some features like fillets and chamfers do not require a sketch and can be applied directly to an existing feature. You will cover basic feature commands all the way through intermediate features. You also have many lessons on testing your newly acquired skills. Following the lessons on features and part creation, you will move on to assemblies. In an assembly, you apply similar relations as you apply to sketches. However, we call these relations mates. Just as sketch relations define conditions such as tangency, parallelism, and concentricity with respect to sketch geometry, assembly mates define equivalent relations with respect to the individual parts or components, allowing the easy construction of assemblies. In the assembly lessons, you will cover standard mates along with a few intermediate assembly techniques. You will conclude the video with more than 20 lessons on how to create 2D drawings. Drawings can be created from either parts or assemblies. You will cover the necessary techniques to generate views, notes, dimensions, and tolerances from the part and assembly model. You will also examine how to create bill of materials and custom drawing templates. Now, since you know what you will cover throughout the lessons in this video training, let's move on so you can learn more about SOLIDWORKS 2015.